Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to feature Panther 2. And you are wondering, but why skill Panther 2? Well, if you would pay attention, there we have the E50M line as a top of the tree, and I think some people might grind it. So why the heck not to play with Panther 2, E50 and E50M? And obviously we are going to make a separate video, so maybe you will get some tips and tricks how to play with those tanks. First of all, what is the good thing about the Panther 2 is the gun. DPM is fine, accuracy is good, shell speed, velocity and everything, and that's about it, and everything else is bad. I am being honest, fellas, and I'm saying that straight into the face. I did 2 warming up rounds before I started recording the video. First game was very, very nice, close to 3000 combined. The second game was lower than 2000 combined. And sometimes I need to warm up with the tanks like this. So this is very, very important thing. And after warming up is done for me, we can actually start our journey, shall we? So the first battle which we are getting is Lakeville tier 9 Stuartus. It is okay, we will try to make it work. Overall, the Panther 2, whenever you are bottom tier shitter, you are playing very, very passively and you are having a safe defense parameter in a way, at least in my opinion. Whenever you are playing against the tier 6 or tier 7s, then obviously you can be so much more aggressive and you can show who is the boss in this kind of situation. But other than that, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, do not have hopes to have any armor whatsoever with a Panther 2 or to bounce shot or 2. For example, whenever someone will see you with a T30, he is going to think about you. Snack, two-shotable snack. This is how people are treating Panther 2, and once again, this is completely understandable, and no one could blame them, at least in my humble opinion. So, let's start our journey. First things first. What do we want to do? We want to have a safe defense parameter, and from the safe defense parameter, we will try to beat the living hell. Or perimeter. Someone said skill, you are talking absolutely utter pile of garbage. Not parameter, perimeter. Perimeter it is. So, once again, all we need to do, we need to be very patient here, and we need to wait until enemies will make a mistake or until they will simply get spotted, which is very, very possible. So with this tank, what you are capable of doing, obviously you are capable of blindshotting the living hell out of everyone, and as you can see, our guys are going ham there. I'm definitely not only one which is going for a blind shot. We have Kapaza, we had the CS53, which was joining the train of the blind shots, which is not bad by any means. Now, the very tricky thing with the tanks like this is when enemies have no team, you are starting everything with a safe defense perimeter, and pretty much you are not getting enough use for yourself just because you play it safe. This kind of situation definitely can happen, and it's definitely very, very annoying, but in the same time, you cannot change anything there, and you need to accept this. Not every game is going to be epic. For example, we had a video with this vehicle 4 months ago, and the average performance of our score was, if I'm not mistaken, correct me if I'm wrong, like 2,500, and this is very, very low score for me, but in the same time it happens, and I know I cannot change it, and I'm not even planning to. You know, I like, whenever I'm doing the live replays, I like to show you how the things are looking like for real. Yes, sometimes we are having not the best performances. Sometimes we are having a salty skill, which is saying, and so on. And you know what? This is the beauty of this kind of performance, in my humble opinion. And I'm saying this because it is absolutely the case. Garage, beautiful. This guy is going back to the garage himself, which is very nice. And now we are going to beat the living crap out of the Mr. Chrysler. We can try to track him, which we did successfully. And now we can send him back home, which will definitely happen. Very nice. This performance is already very, very good. Obviously, it's not over yet. We still can get plenty of use if we won't do some silly things, if we will think what we are doing. Now, the tier 9 50 TP, I will probably load the gold shells for 50 TP, just in case. If we won't penetrate, if we would not penetrate with the standard ones, I do not want to take any silly risks. And I think he just fired. So what that means, if he just fired, we can go sideways for him and we can start beating the living crap out of him. I think I'm going for another one, and here we go. Beautiful. Even though he eliminated our friend, we don't really care too much, and this guy is dead in a second. Nice. Very good. We have the object, which is sitting in the back. We have a Starva, Panther 2, and a Mike Sada. So let's make a pressure. Now we are saying meatball serve for us. I repeat, meatball serve for us. The T95 is pushing in front like there is no tomorrow. And that's very, very good. He will take quite a bit of damage from the guys which is sniping from the red line right there. Our Roo is doing extremely good job by spotting, obviously, and object never ever was spotted. That indicates for us he is sitting either here, or maybe even either here, 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 or right here. So, let's see. There is two clickers, two Jeffs, which is obviously sitting here next to the red line. At least it's supposed to be the case. And object is, what the flying F? Object never spotted, and the very first time whenever he's getting spotted, he's having 400 HP. What is this sorcery? It doesn't make any sense whatsoever. I mean, we went ham with the blind shots there, so maybe we managed to penetrate him and lit him on fire, or maybe our other guy did the same thing. Anyways, 2,200 damage, big fat thumbs up from my side, and 1,000 assisting damage. Now, let's see how many blind shots did we hit. I'm very curious, or did we hit any blind shots? Maybe I'm just simply talking shit. You never know, so let's see. 2.2 visible. Moment of truth. 2,500. So we hit someone with a blind shot, and it was probably the same object. Poor same object. Okay, very, very nice. I'm super happy with this performance. We are second by experience. We are first by the damage. Definitely great game with a Panther 2. And as you can see, this time can definitely work. All you need to do, you need to play a bit passivier with a Panther 2 until you can make pressure. And when you can make pressure, you are going in front. If you can't make pressure, you are sniping from the red line. And I know it is very, very weird stuff overall, but it's just how it works. Okay, what do we want to do now? And what is the plan? So we have a tier 9 matchmaking, which is definitely not the best matchmaking for the Panther. So far, both of the case scenarios wasn't even equal tier. It was, unfortunately, we are bottom tiers all the time, but luckily only plus 1 matchmaking, not plus 2. So what do we want to do now? I would say we want to take this position, and from this position we can punish everyone which is trying to cross through the middle. And sometimes it happens when people are trying to do the shortcuts, and if people are trying to do the shortcuts, we are going to get some advantage from them. I do not understand how this map is working, because sometimes those planes are extremely loud and sometimes they are very, very silent. So honestly, with all respect, I do not know how it works, and I apologize if it is too loud. Good. So We are in position. This is exactly what we want to see, and this is what we need. So the first things first, IS-6 is going up, that's okay. We have all time in the world of tanks. Borats and Kapazander is making a hardcore pressure there, which is absolutely insanity if you would ask me, but I wish them luck. Meanwhile, CS, tier 9 Polish medium tank decided to take the simple position there, which is not very useful, at least in my opinion. I haven't seen a single person having a very great game by playing there, honestly. And I'm not making this shit up. But maybe this game will work in his favor. We'll see. A lot of people are playing in the heavy line. In fact, I believe that's pretty clear. Enemies have a lemming train, I would say. So how we could make the things work? Maybe we could get a bit more involved and maybe cross like this. But the question is, would we have a bit support there? I am thinking about being more involved, but by saying more involved, I mean more involved, you know, to the maximum. So let's try to cross like this. Let's select auto aim for this guy, hit him in the face, which is always nice and always welcome. Since he is trying just to react now, I am going to hit him once again. That's very good. And this is how we are having our start, which is once again pretty damn nice. If you would ask me, going for another one until he is trying to position himself, and we are having a pretty damn good start. Already 1.3 thousand damage, which is not bad whatsoever. Can we see a single person sitting here? Unfortunately, we cannot. Interesting. And ISU is thinking about going back for a base defense. So ISU is thinking, aha, Panther, yum 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 yum. You know what I'm doing for a Panthers? I am eating them for breakfast. And now Panther is smacking ISU. And you know what, ISU, you better run. Oh, you better run. You better run, you bastard. Schnai in the face. Now he's, maybe he's down to one shotable if I'm going to be lucky. Unfortunately, I am not, but that's completely fine. There is a pan, Jack Tiger, which is sitting in the back, and now we are going to have a farming simulator if everything will go well. Unfortunately, it is not going that well as I initially thought it will, but that's completely fine. Now look, ISU is dead, excellent. How about the same Jack Tiger? He's not paying attention at us. That's absolutely amazing. We are trying to track him. He is tracked, and now, fellas, we have a bit of the problems. You know what? Do not make Jack Tiger angry, because Jack Tiger have all abilities to beat the living crap out of you without even asking your name. Trust me on this one. Now Jack Tiger is saying, no, do you want to F with me? Do you want to F with me? And I'm saying, sure thing, why the heck not? And Jack Tiger is going for us. Now I'm trying to make a bit different angle, but unfortunately I'm stuck right here, which is completely fine. I'm bouncing another shot, which is not very good. I'm trying to run away before it's too late. That's okay. Dede Fede. Par, 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 par. Skill what Dede Fede does. Par, 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 par. Boom, into the track. I don't really think he has a repair kit. Luckily he doesn't. And now we are saying, nyom, nyom, nyom. You know, I love you with all my heart. You are so damn cute whenever you are smiling, and he is dead. Excellent. There is still one Arta. I am extremely well aware of this, but that's okay. Can we hit this guy? Absolutely. Yes, amazing shot. Very good. Chinese tank should miss because it's China. Ha ha ha. You did not saw that one coming, did you? And can we get one more shot, pretty please? Absolutely, yes, we can. Trying to side scrap because it's Chinese tank and Chinese to nothing. Poor soul, I mean T-34/2. Such an unlucky player with unlucky tank. So damn bad. Anyways, look at this performance. 4000 damage and 600 assisting damage. Absolutely gorgeous performance. And we did, in my humble opinion, we did everything properly. We decided to make a pressure when we needed to. We noticed that where majority of the enemies are playing, and overall that was was a bloody great game, honestly. Solid Ace Vanquer, in my opinion, well deserved. 4000 damage, 600 assisting damage. Very, very, very nice. 1.2 base experience. Beautiful, beautiful game, fellas. Nice. And 37,000 profits, which is always welcome. Okay, let's go for a last game. Ooh, fellas. Ooh. We are having a pretty damn good time, if you would ask me. I'm enjoying myself. I don't know how about you, but I really do. So, what is the plan? Skill? Okay, my plan is to get Earfeld with two artists. Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay. Quite sad, honestly. But not much what we can change there. Okay, so, my friends, we need to make this this battle work. I want to get somehow 3,000 combined and I would be super happy because in my humble opinion, the Panther 2 video is already a great success and I believe you see this tank can work with this beautiful gun. But now, how to make it work? I truly don't like this map and especially with Artis. But I believe how we could start everything. There is many tank destroyers, so people should not make much pressure whatsoever. It should be long game. Considering how many artists and how many tank destroyers. So how we are going to start everything, I'm going to take the typical position there just to spot who is trying to play here. Or maybe to get some sneaky shot. Meanwhile, holy bananas from Banana Land. The super Hellcat going for a full and he is dead. GG, well played. Okay, listen, and before shit talking this guy, I can understand his frustration. Neither this map is good, neither this matchmaking is good, so probably he is having a bit of the sad game, so he decided just to YOLO in. And it's better to YOLO in than to drown yourself in the first minute of the battle, honestly. In my humble opinion, it is way better to just do this. Die if you are dead disappointed in everything and for a next time, maybe the game will treat you a bit better. Once again, I'm not afraid to say so, it's still better than drowning, don't you think so? So, IS3, hello you cute meatball, how are you doing? Boom into the track, beautiful, can we get a tracking shot right here? 3, 2, 1, could you please stop it? And tracking shot, and he is dead. Did the T30 eliminated him from the game? Definitely yes. And we are having extremely good start already. Our team is winning this battle by 4000 HP. Score is 0-3, which is very, very good for us for obvious reasons. And yeah, okay, what we can do next? Meanwhile, poor Dede Fede is sniping from the back. I am paranoid by the artist, don't worry, I am. I am very, very well aware that they are sitting there and this is not going to be very fun. But in the same time, I know we have some Jeffs too. So our Jeffs should be able to maybe punish the Dede Fede. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful game. Okay, what to do now? I honestly do not want to escape from here. I think we are sitting in very great position. I'm not even thinking about relocating yet. How about the shot to the T30? Hello there, mister. Boom straight into the face of the T30. T30 is dead. Yeah, this is game over. Listen, in this kind of situation, enemies have absolutely nothing to do, unfortunately, for the enemy team. This is very, very sad, very bad, but once again, they can't change it. So now we are going to do some things for entertaining purposes. You know what Panther is good for? Ramming. Skill, what do you mean ramming? Well, if you would pay attention. Oh boy, how you enjoyed yourself. Did you have a great time? Because honestly, I did. I had a blast. I had... That was beautiful. Okay, next. What to do now? E75, which is sitting here in the bag, beautiful. Can we beat the living crap out of the poor E75? Enemies have no team. This is 15-1 simulator, as usual in the World of Tanks, but you can say whatever you want. We are beating the living hell out of the Panther 2, and I'm actually surprised. I am surprised in a good way how the things are looking like. Now, two Artas. I'm going to load high explosive ammunition for Jeffs because I believe we should be able to penetrate them, and hopefully we can send them back to the garage in one shot. That's one, beautiful. And now another one. Where is the other clicker? Another clicker is sitting here in the corner. Can we please eliminate him from the game from one shot? Sure thing we can, even though that wasn't a full penetration, speaking about the damage, but it is completely fine. Okay, ML2 is there, T25 is there, Tortoise is there. I believe we should be able to find a nice angle to beat the living crap out of Tortoise in approximately 7 seconds. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, okay, he's dead before that. That's fine. I should be able to hit him from there, but once again, I can't change this. By the way, fellas, that's World of Tanks Blitz. The full video, 3 games made in 20 minutes. 3 games, 20 minutes, done. GG, finito, with all intro, with everything. Acto, now what happened to the World of Tanks? Katita, I'm telling you, World of Tanks is crazy, honey. Crazy. Even Cat is thinking, what the flying F is this? Or maybe Cat is asking to open the window. Probably that's what she is asking for. So, what do we have? 3000 damage, 1,100 assisting damage. I mean, I do not know what I supposed to say. It is just amazing performance. We are second by experience, we are first by the damage. We are making shit ton of profit. We did not fire too many gold shells whatsoever in this video, and our average performance is 3,200 damage and 950 assisting damage. Call me disgusting, but this is a great performance. So, my friends, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, last time when we had the video with the Panther 2, everything went bad, and now everything went good. And I simply can't change anything. It's just how World of Tanks is working. So my friends, if you are having a bad time in the game, I sincerely apologize for that, because we had quite a bit of situations in the Twitch when people is saying, "Skill, I'm having a bad time," and so on in the game. I'm sorry. Everyone can have the situation when everything is going against you, but remember, there is always another day, and hopefully another day will be better for all of us, right? Thank you very much for watching, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you had a great time watching Panther in action. Remember to smack one of those. I would appreciate that a lot. And see you very, very soon. Skill is out. Peace.